Where is the rest of the people? Don't know.
Vamos a continuar con los ejercicios del libro, ¿no, profe?
Yes, of course. So, I think it's time enough. I think it's enough time to continue with the class. So, let's start by correcting this exercise. Have you finished? Have you finished this exercise?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, so One moment, please. Okay. So let's start by writing the present passive and past passive voice in these sentences. So the first one was, what classic toy? Not writing. No, Roger. Okay, what? No, Roger, carajo. What classic toy was created more than 40 years ago? What is the translation of this sentence? I'm gonna put...
El juguete ha sido creado hace más de 40 años.
Yes, very good. Bien. Okay, could you find another one? Everyone knows this 3D dust is sold all around the world. This 3D puzzle that is sold all around the world. That is another sentence. What is the translation of this sentence?
Este puzzle 3D que es vendido alrededor del mundo.
Bien. It is one of the most successful products of all time. More than 350 million cubes have been sold since it was invented. This is another passive, but it is present perfect passive voice. What is the meaning of this? More than 350 million cubes have been sold since it was invented.
Más de 350 millones de cubos se han vendido desde que se inventó.
Muy bien. The first prototype was created. This is another phrase by Ernest Rubik. It was called the magic cube. This is another. It was called the magic cube. And this is past passive. Success came in the early 80s. When the product license was bought by an American toy manufacturer. So this is another one. The product license was bought by an American toy manufacturer. It was then renamed the Rubik's Cube. It was then renamed the Rubik's Cube is another phrase in which we can find a passive voice, past passive voice. Bien, listo. ¿Han corregido esa parte? Bueno, entonces, vamos a saltar por acá. Ahí. No quedó así como yo lo tenía. Bueno, no importa. Bueno, acá. It soon became an international sensation in the middle when the toy was most popular. It was estimated that as much as 1/5 of the world's population had tried solving the Rubik's Cube. It was estimated is another phrasing passive voice. What is it? It was estimated. Then go down. Go down, go down. And the cube still has fans all over the world today. Yearly speed cubing competitions. Here you have another one. Yearly, anualmente, speed cubing competitions are organized. This is another phrase in passive voice. To see who can solve the cube the fastest. The competitions take place each year in every continent in the world. The only place it hasn't been solved is space. The only place it hasn't been solved is space. El único lugar donde no ha sido resuelto es en el espacio. Yet, at least, aún por lo menos. The record time for solving the cube is currently 5.55 seconds. Other competitions include solving the cube underwater in a single breath and solving it one-handed or with the feet. The most expensive cube was created in 1995. This is another phrase. And let's go finally to see. A normal cube is made of plastic. A normal cube is made of plastic. The masterpiece cube was made. The masterpiece cube was made of solid gold and was covered in jewels. Un cubo normal es hecho de plástico, pero el cubo maestro fue hecho de oro sólido y fue convertido o fue cubierto, perdón, de joyas. It costs $1.5 million. The Rubik's Cube is one classic toy that has earned its place in game history. ¿Listo? Bueno, esa fue la forma en que podían subrayar este ejercicio. Entonces, después me pueden enviar los resultados, su trabajo a mi WhatsApp para yo revisar. Bueno, el siguiente punto es, vayan ahí donde está el punto cuarto, dice, complete the information with the phrases in the box. Complete la información con las frases que aparecen en esta caja, en este recuadro. Entonces, lo único que tienen que hacer es leer y completar. Y completar. ¿Listo? De acuerdo a su interpretación. Entonces, vayan haciendo. You have 10 minutes for this. From now, come on, solve it, solve it. Los que no tienen libro, eso sí pueden copiarlo en sus cuadernos. And you have 10 minutes. Come on.
Profesor, es que había llegado tarde. ¿Me podría volver a explicar en qué están trabajando?
Bueno, ya hicimos el punto anterior, que era el de subrayar en el texto. Ahora, en este The Flying Disc, tienes que completar la información con las palabras que aparecen aquí en el recuadro.
Listo, gracias, profesor.
Listo. Ok. Ten minutes to finish this. Come on.
Profe, es que no puedo ver las palabras.
¿No alcanzas a ver?
Sí, sí.
Okay.
No aparece.
Sorry. Aquí sí. Bien.
Profe, qué pena, puede mover el mouse que está tapando una palabra.
Ok.
Profe, una pregunta. ¿Qué significa was designed?
Was redesigned?
Yeah.
It's... Redesigned. Rediseñado.
Ok, thank you.
Fue rediseñado. Redesigned. Have you finished?
Profe, hay algo sobre la pantalla que no me deja ver.
Oh, lo siento. Sorry. Okay, three minutes left.
Profe, ¿lo puedo bajar un poquito, por favor?
Yes, of course. Ahí.
Okay, okay, ya terminé.
Does anybody else finish?
No, teacher, put a minute, please.
Okay. A second. It's 1 minute to finish. It's 1 minute to finish this activity.
Pero puede ser un momento para las palabras de arriba. Ya, gracias.
Okay, the time is over. Okay, time is over. Let's correct this exercise. Wait for me a minute because someone is to tell me something by the chat. One moment, please. Let's see a bit. Okay, now let's correct this exercise, and I need you participate in these exercises to give you more positive points. Okay, so the flying disc. The flying disc, what is the word for this blank?
Was invented.
Okay,
was very invented.
Good. Very good. Was invented. So writing it. Write in this space, please. Okay. Was invented. Was invented. Flying disc was invented by Walter Morrison in 1948. At first, it. Another was person, please.
Was called.
Okay, was called. Called. Was called. Was called the flying saucer, and it
was sold.
And it was sold. Who said that? ¿Quién dijo eso?
Was bought.
¿Quién dijo la primera? Was sold. Michael, yeah. Was sold. Sí, está bien. Was sold. And it was sold on beaches in California. Okay, on beaches in California. Then in 1957, the idea
was redesigned.
What do you think about? Is this correct?
Was given.
Was given?
I'm not sure.
I think it's well to say redesigned. Redesigned. Redesigned.
Pero esa no va en la 6.
Bueno, analicémosla bien. Entonces, a ver. The disc so that it was easier to throw accurately. Bien. Dejemos esta en blanco mientras la analizamos bien. ¿Listo? By one, and the disc, a new name. And the disc was, ¿qué? Was all what invented, was given, was a is made. What do you put at this sentence?
Was given.
Very good. Was given a new name. En este caso no traduce como fue dado, sino como se le dio. Se le dio un nuevo nombre. Was given. Was given a new name. Frisbee. The disc. The disc so that it was easier to throw accurately. ¿Perdón?
Iría was redesigned y en la 4 iría was bought by 1-0.
Entonces, the disc was redesigned so that it was easier to throw accurately. Millions of frisbees. Millions of frisbees. ¿Qué iría acá? La única que tiene where, ¿no? Was where sold.
Where sold.
Millions of frisbees were sold. And frisbee became a new sport. Nowadays, there are many varieties of frisbees, including a knife frisbee that is made. Ahí colocaría, no me alcanza ahí la pantalla, pero coloquen is made. Y en la cuarta sí iba la que nos faltaba. ¿Cuál?
Was bought.
Okay, ahora sí, la idea fue vendida. perdón, fue comprada por, was both. The idea was both. Fue comprada por one of, and the disc was given a new name, Frisbee. The disc was redesigned so that it was easier to throw accurately. Millions of Frisbees were sold and Frisbee became a new sport. Okay, very good. And you have it in this way? ¿La tienen de esta forma?
Yes, teacher.
Yes.
Okay, just... Now, let's complete this exercise with the last point that is very, very, very easy because you just have to put the verb into the correct form of the past participle tense, including the was, including the was or were. Complete the test with the correct form of the verbs in the parentheses. Skateboarding was invented. This is so easy. Was invented in California in the 1950s. The first skateboards. ¿Qué colocaríamos acá?
Was used.
Incorrect.
Was used.
Incorrect. The first skateboards is a plural name. So instead of using was,
where?
You use where. Where is
where,
it?
Where used by.
Yes, exactly the same. Where used by? Used by surfers. They
made.
They were made.
They were
Muy
made.
Bien. They were made.
Muy bien, Nick. They were made. Of wooden boxes with wheels on the bottom. At that time, skateboarding
was called.
Muy bien.
Profesa, también se tiene que copiar.
Was called. Si quieres tomar el pantallazo y después la copias, no hay problema. Ese también hace parte de los ejercicios. Pero como yo sé que de pronto te demorarías más, entonces solo toma el pantallazo y continúa y lo escribes en el cuaderno o lo escribes en la casa o me envías el mismo pantallazo, no hay problema. Sidewalk surfing. It became widely popular when new plastic wheels were developed. In the 1970s, and the sport what do you use in this case?
Was adopted.
Yes, easy. Was adopted by a new generation of teenagers who skated faster and perform more tricks. Nowadays, many skateboards
were decorated.
Bien, en este caso no los culpo si les queda mal, porque como habla de hoy en día, ¿sí? O sea, se está hablando de algo del pasado, pero se toma de algo de hoy en día. Por lo tanto, vamos a usar el pasivo perfecto. Entonces, many skateboards have been decorated. Have been decorated. ¿Sí? ¿Captan? Puede ser un poco confuso, pero esta es la construcción correcta de esta oración. Many skateboards have been decorated. Han sido decoradas. Con beautiful art, con arte hermoso, que muestra la personalidad de sus propietarios. Entonces, este ejercicio estaba, ¿qué hice? No estaba tan difícil. Entonces, simplemente completarlo. Si pueden tomarle el pantallazo porque ya nos queda poquito tiempo, está bien, no hay problema. Ahí está. ¿Sí se ve bien? De hecho, incluso en este caso, es válido usar was adopted, pero como están hablando de new generations, podemos usar has been adopted, ¿sí? Para decir algo así como, y el deporte ha sido adoptado por las nuevas generaciones de jóvenes, quienes patinan más rápido y hacen mejores trucos. ¿Listo? Bueno, si ya tienen completos estos ejercicios, pueden írmelos enviando a mi chat de WhatsApp, ¿vale? Para yo tener constancia de que ustedes han trabajado durante las clases.